Hi guys, so welcome back to the channel. I know it's been a while since I have put out a video. It's been kind of crazy. We've had a lot of things going on. The baby got sick twice. We're getting ready to move again. And I had my aunt come and visit us, so it's been very, very busy, but I wanted to make sure that I got this video out before our upcoming trip. So these are things that we bring with us on a Fort Wilderness trip to Disney. And I should tell you guys that we always drive to Florida, and so even when we were living in New Jersey, we still drove, and we were able to bring all these things in the car. So if you are going to be taking a plane, some of these items are not going to work for you, but you might be able to find something to substitute these items with. So let's get started with the first item that I like to bring with us, and it is a drying rack for clothing. So this comes in handy for drying up bathing suits, drying up the towels, the swimming towels, and other items like that. So if you are going to be taking a plane, you can always use Fort Wilderness's dryers to dry up your clothes, or you can lay them inside of the bathtub in the RV. But for me, I feel like this really helps us out. We kind of just leave it outside, we throw our stuff over, and it just helps keep everything getting dry for the next time that we want to go to the pool. And this is a great thing to have, and I will be linking all of these things in the description box below, but most of these items came from Amazon. The next thing that I like to bring is a laundry hamper, and this is just a pop-up hamper that I got from Walmart. I think it was about $7, and I like to bring this because I do not pack up everything right away, which I don't think most people do, but I like to have this. I throw it inside the camper. I pretty much bring two of these for each camper that we rent. This time we have two because my aunt is coming, but if we just have one camper, it's one hamper, and we all just kind of throw our clothes in it. Once the hamper is full, I start packing up the suitcases and putting them into the van, and this just kind of keeps all the clothes separate so that when we do pack up, sometimes we have clean clothes left over. All the clean clothes go in one suitcase, all the dirty clothes go in another suitcase, and then we wash them when we come home. So this is really nice to keep the clothes off the floor. Everything goes in one spot, and it's nice and neat because with a camper you do have a smaller space. Having the hamper is going to help you keep things organized while you're during your stay. So the next thing that we bring is beach towels. And the reason why we bring beach towels is because Meacham's provides bath towels, and I don't like to bring the bath towels to the pool. So we bring our own towels, and this is actually really nice because you don't have to worry, you know, if you forget it by the pool, or you leave it somewhere, or if it gets really dirty, that you're damaging their property. So we like to bring our own beach towels with us when we go to Fort Wilderness, and there you go, we dry them on the rack. Okay, the next thing is that you're going to want to bring, if you are going to be renting with Meacham the fire pit, you're definitely going to want to bring some of these fire starters. If you get the fire pit and wood bundle, you have everything you need to start a fire, except that you won't have these fire starters. So these are really good to bring. I do believe that Fort Wilderness has them in the gift shop. I will double check on that though when we're there, and I'll let you guys know, but Steve's nodding that yes, they do have them. So if you forget them or if you're flying, you can pick them up in the gift shop, but definitely grab those before you try to start a fire, because I don't know if anybody that's doing this is doing it for the first time. Fire is not an easy thing to start. Trust me, I have tried many times. In the past, we used to have a fire pit outside of our house, and these things are really they just make it so much easier. And this one is the kind that you literally just light the plastic wrap and it just ignites. This one is a more natural, if you're kind of like more of a natural person and you want to bring your own. They do have like a natural fire starter, but definitely fire starters are going to be something that you want to bring or make sure you get at the gift. Another thing that I like to bring is a wet bag. And so these are the wet bags that I got for this year. You can use any type of bag that you want, but if you're going to be using the comfort stations, these wet bags do come in handy because it can hold your wet stuff and your dry stuff. So in this pocket in the back, you can keep your unmentionables and your clothes and whatever's going to fit in here. And then in the front pouch, you can keep your wet stuff. So when you go into the shower, you just grab a little Ziploc bag with your shampoo, conditioner, body wash. If you are the type of person that brushes your teeth in the shower, you can also do that there. This is just my little bag that I have with my toiletries, and it's going to keep everything separate. So when you're going over to the comfort station, it's nice to just have a little bag to put your stuff in so that you don't forget something or, you know, whatever. But these bags come in handy. I did get these on Amazon as a bundle. They came to be like $4 each, so it wasn't really a bad price for the bags. But yeah, so we all have this, and this is a great item to bring with you on your trip. Those little toiletries, just keep everything nice and easy. When you go into the bathrooms of Fort Wilderness, you definitely want to have some sort of Crocs or sandals on your feet, because you are going to go into a dry space where you can take them off if you don't want to shower in Crocs, and then you're going to go into a wet space. So you would take your bag, go into the dry space, you can remove the plastic bag, and then there's a little shelf inside of the shower area where you can put your toiletries, and so that's another thing that's good to bring. Another thing that this is new for this year that I'm bringing, but and we've really never had a problem with mosquitoes, but this is a mosquito candle, and it's an all-natural mosquito repellent. Anytime I use bug spray or anything, I use natural products. It's just, that's me personally, that's what I like. But I find that the natural products work really, really well. We don't really use DEET, so I do bring bug spray. This time I'm gonna bring the candles to see if we can just light it while we're at our campsite, because we do plan on spending a lot of extra time at the campsite this year. I got two of these. I'm gonna light these and see how they work, but I've read a lot of good reviews. I got these on Amazon as well, and they were highly rated, so I hope that they work. Although, like I'm saying, we've never really had too much problems with mosquitoes. I think I probably got one mosquito bite in all the years that we were at Fort Wilderness, and we did use bug spray, but I don't know if it was the bug spray or the fact that there were really not very many bugs. So, but this is something that I recommend bringing, some sort of bug spray or bug candles. Great. The next thing that you definitely don't want to forget is going to be roasting sticks. So even if you're not planning on renting a fire pit with Meacham's, every night Disney will start two fires in the Meadows area where you can bring hot dogs, marshmallows, your own chocolates, and graham crackers to roast s'mores.
Is it called the Campfire Sing-Along?
It used to be called the Campfire Sing-Along. Right now they're not doing a sing-along, and they're not seeing Chip and Dale. I was hoping that we would see Chip and Dale this time, because the baby, I don't even know why, but she loves Chip and Dale, and she loves them. So I was hoping that they were going to, bring back the Campfire Sing-Along, but they're not. But they are still doing movies, and where you see the movie is the same place that you're going to see the campfires, and there are two of them, and they really don't get very crowded. But this year we decided to get some reusable roasting sticks, and we used to buy the wooden ones, and those work really well. It's just that after you use them, you have to throw them out, and I am pretty much on a mission to start eliminating all single-use products from my life. That's just my goal, but I thought these were pretty good because you can clean them, they store up really small, and everybody can get their own color. And so you definitely want to have some sort of roasting sticks with you. I've never actually seen them have the roasting sticks, so I can't say, but I do know that they do sell s'mores kits. So if you're coming on a plane and you want to buy a s'mores kit to roast s'mores at the fire, you can totally do that. if you are going to be driving and you want to grab, you know, s'mores before you come and bring them, you can do that too. The thing about Fort Wilderness that I find to be interesting is that at Fort Wilderness, they do not provide anything for free as far as the fire pit goes. But if you go to, let's say, the Animal Kingdom Lodge, or where was the other place we went?
Where Animation. They Art of Animation.
Oh, Art of Animation. They provide you with marshmallows and roasting sticks. And it's just kind of funny, I guess, because people tend to come and they're in their campers and they're camping, so they figure people would have that automatically. But if you, it's just an interesting thing that they do, that they don't provide anything for you at Fort Wilderness. You have to buy it yourself. But I thought that these were really cute, and you can wash them. And these I also got on Amazon for a very cheap price. I think I paid $12 for all 8 of these. So when I was buying roasting sticks, I was paying $2 for a pack of 4. I had to buy 2 packs. So this just, overall, it just saves me money, and it saves the environment a little bit. Okay, next thing. So I always bring these laundry baskets, and these are actually for your shoes. And so what I like to do is, because you can't wear, you're not allowed to wear your shoes inside the camper, it's to prevent a lot of dirt from being brought in.
And scuffing up the floor.
So you can actually bring this basket inside of the camper, and you can actually bring your shoes in the camper at night if you want to. You can put them by the door. They just don't want people walking around the campers with their shoes on. But for us, since I have 5 children, it just makes it easier to remind them to take their shoes off with the basket. We put it right outside of the door, and before you go in, you just kind of take your shoes off, you throw them inside of the basket, and that's the end of the shoes. So it works out really, really well for us. We've always done it ever since the first year. We've always brought a little basket. At night, if it's not going to rain, we just kind of tuck it underneath the camper. If it is, there is a risk of rain, we just kind of bring it in and put it right by the door, and it works out really well. Okay, so yeah, if you rent a golf cart with Meacham's, you'll soon realize when you get to Disney that every single golf cart looks the same. And if you are not a person that is very attentive to detail, you're gonna lose your golf cart. It's so funny how they all just basically look the same. And a lot of people do have golf carts. They bring golf carts, they rent golf carts, and they're pretty much all the same. So what you can do, sometimes people bring little decorations, they'll put little lights on it, they'll put garlands, but anything to just kind of say, hey, this is ours, you know? And that way when you go looking for it, you spot your little thing right away to hang on your golf cart. It is helpful, so. We don't do it. I mean, we've never done that, right?
Mm-hmm.
But a lot of people do it, and it seems to be something fun. So if you plan on going in October or November or December, and they're having, you know, the Christmas party or the Halloween party, everybody's going to be having decorations. So that's just kind of something fun to do, is to decorate your golf cart with lights or something festive. So another thing that you definitely want to try and bring with you is going to be tablecloths for the tables outside if you plan to eat outside. I get these at Walmart, and sometimes they have a package that includes these little clips to clip the tablecloth to the table, and it just keeps it in place, which is really nice. I basically bought these a couple years ago, and I just keep reusing them because I wipe them down afterwards and they stay pretty neat. They did have these last year at Walmart. They had the Disney ones, so we do have the Grogu and the Minnie Mouse, but you can get these plain tablecloths as well, whatever works better for your family or for whoever's going. And these clips are definitely something that you would benefit from, just because it'll stay on the table if it gets windy or anything like that. But yeah, this is another thing that I recommend bringing to you to Fort Wilderness for your camper reservation. Another thing that we actually really like to bring is sidewalk chalk if you have children. And you basically get a whole space, a parking space, and then there's a little space on the side. It's just a pad. And the kids really, really enjoy doing sidewalk chalk there. And so we always bring sidewalk chalk. It just gives them something to do in the meantime, you know, if you're doing dishes or cleaning up or whatever, you know, you can, the kids can go out and they can play with sidewalk chalk. And we've done that pretty much every year. This year we were trying to come up with a little design so that it was kind of a family design that we wanted to do on the ground, but we've been so busy we haven't even had a chance to sit down and try to do that. But if we do, I'll try to show it in the video. Also, if you have any questions or if you would like to see anything that I've mentioned or anything that you're curious about, leave it in the comments below and I will really try very hard to make sure that I show those things throughout our trip. We did make reservations in advance to do a trail ride. So we're gonna do the trail ride while we're at Four Wilderness. We plan to rent a boat, one of the pontoons. We do plan to, what else are we gonna do? We're gonna eat at, we're actually gonna do this really fun thing that I don't think very many people know about. It's painting. And so I don't know if many of you guys know or if anybody knows about a place called Pinot's Palettes. That's what it was in New Jersey, but it's basically like a wine and paint type of situation where you you go and they teach you how to paint a portrait of something, and it's going to be a Disney themed portrait. And they actually give you, for people that want alcohol, they provide an alcoholic drink and some snacks. And then for those not drinking alcohol, it's just like, you know, fountain beverages and snacks. And then you sit and you paint something. And so we're actually going to be doing that during this trip. I'm actually really excited about it because I did a Pinot's Palettes once before. And it was fun. You know, it is a fun activity. I will do a review of the camper when we get there and everything. So definitely stay tuned. If you are not subscribed to the channel, hit that subscribe button so that you don't miss out on what's to come for the channel. Definitely all of the Fort Wilderness stuff. Give it a like if you enjoyed this video and share it with your friends. I really appreciate all of you guys that are watching. So thank you for watching. That is going to do it for us for today. And we will see you next time.